The name Shawnee is derived from the Algonquin word Chowanagi, meaning southerners. The Shawnee are classified as northeastern Indians due to the fact that they farmed, fished, and hunted. The head of the Shawnee tribe was named Tecumseh. The Shawnee believed in Monedo, a supreme being who ruled the entire universe and distributed blessings upon all who entered his favor and desperate sorrow to those who were in his bad standing. A ceremony practiced by the Shawnee was called the naming ceremony. The naming ceremony took place after the birth of a child. The parents would choose two people called the name givers from the tribe to pray for a name. The mother of the child had to remain secluded from the baby during the entire ceremony. Once the name givers had a dream about the baby's name, the mother would come out of seclusion and the final decision was made by the mother. If the mother disagreed with the name, then she could choose what the baby's name could be. After the decision was made, the father gave one of the name givers a string of white beads to tie around the baby's neck, which would be worn until the string broke. If the baby had fallen with an illness, a name-changing ceremony would be organized because it was believed that two people could not have the same name. Many important ceremonies were tied to agriculture. The spring dance at planting time, the green corn dance when crops ripened, and the autumn bread dance to celebrate the harvest. Each clan had its own duties to the tribe. One was responsible for warfare and training of warriors for battle. One was for matters pertaining to food, health, and medicine. The other two most powerful clans were responsible for the overall tribal government and politics. The Shawnee did not live in teepees. They lived in wigwams, which are small, round dwellings. In 1774, the Shawnee rebelled when the governor of Virginia, the Earl of Dunmore, ignored the proclamation of 1763. Signed by the King of England, promising an Indian country west of the Appalachians. When the settlers came to stake their claims, the Shawnee, led by Chief Cornstalk, attacked them. Dunmore sent in a force of volunteers to take the land, but was ambushed by the Shawnee on the Kentucky River. Lord Dunmore organized a large army of 1,500 men. Cornstalk asked the Iroquois for help. Most refused to fight their former allies, the British, but Logan, the chief of the Mingo, and some of his warriors joined the Shawnee. On October 6, 1774, the two tribes encountered Dunmore and his army at Point Pleasant, West Virginia. The Indians suffered many casualties in the war. Cornstalk signed a peace treaty with Dunmore in which Shawnee agreed to give up some of their land. In 1809, after the Treaty of Fort Wayne was signed, the United States obtained over 3 million acres, mainly along the Wabash River. The Kickapoo tribe were closely allied with the Shawnee at Prophettown, and Harrison feared they would be difficult to sway. He offered the Wea an increased subsidy if the Kickapoo would also accept the treaty, causing the Wea to pressure the Kickapoo leaders to accept. By the spring of 1810, Harrison had completed negotiations and the treaty was finalized. Tecumseh was outraged by the Treaty of Fort Wayne. Tecumseh revived an idea advocated in previous years by the Shawnee leader Blue Jacket and the Mohawk leader Joseph Brant, which stated that American Indian land was owned in common by all tribes, and thus no land could be sold without agreement by all. To settle this and regain their land, Tecumseh went to war in the Battle of Tippecanoe, but sadly was overpowered by Harrison's army and lost. The Shawnee made bark canoes from the bark of a tree. They made masks out of hay and clay, rattles were made of turtle shells, and they utilized the land to sustain their needs. There are more than 14,000 Shawnee located on reservations in four distinct groups: the Absentee Shawnee, the Eastern Shawnee, and the Cherokee Shawnee, with the Cherokee Nation all in Oklahoma. Though the Shawnee were integrated with the Cherokee, they maintained separate communities and cultural identities. The Cherokee Shawnee would later be called the Loyal Shawnee. In the 1800s, efforts began to separate the Shawnee tribes from the Cherokee Nation. which finally created the Shawnee Tribe Status Act of 2000, which restored the Shawnee tribe to a sovereign Indian nation.